You're going to pray right now. Every devil that is snatching the love for God's word out of your life, you're going to command that devil, get out of my life. Get out of my life. Use your mouth, use your hands. Pray, clap in your hands. Crush that devil, crush that principality. There is an enemy of the word in my life. There is an enemy that is always stationed somewhere to steal the word. The devil knows that if I have the right word, the devil knows that if I have the right word, my God and my Father will fulfill my destiny. Father God Almighty, every infirmity in my life will be flushed out of my system. I come against that devil. I come against that witch. I come against that principality that has been assigned to steal away the word of life, the word of grace. Oh, glory be to God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Be seated. So the word of God, the word of God is the only one that has the capacity to transform a man's character. It is only the word of God that can change every situation. It is only the word of God that can create a lifetime impact. When the word of God settles in your life, what God is going to do with you is going to be eternal. There's nothing like cutting halfway. I don't care the setup of men. I don't care the plans of people against your life. Let the word of God be settled in your life. If the word of God is settled, heaven is settled. The earth will say an amen to it. Hallelujah. That's why the Bible says that when God speaks, his word is eternal. The covenant I've made with heaven, the covenant I've made with the sun and the moon, it is an eternal covenant. And as long as the sun and the moon remain, my covenant with the house of David shall not be broken. Can I announce to you today, I'm initiating you into a new covenant work with the word of God. And when the word of God is the one standing on your life, the word of God is the one settling in your life, the word of God is the one sitting in your heart, I want to announce to you, men may gank up, men may plan, people may rise up against you like a tornado, but God is going to keep you. God is going to preserve you. While others are saying there is a casting down, you will see with your mouth there is a lifting up. Why? What's the secret of your life? The word of God. Because you're abiding in the word of God. You know, Jesus Christ gave us a story and said, a wise man is a man that builds his house upon the word. That's a wise man. He said, the storms of life will come. The shakings will come. Some painful experience that would bring bitter tears from your eyes will come. Trials of life. Nobody is immune to it. It will come from the left to the right. It will come from your family. It will come from your friends. It will come from your colleagues. It will come from your beloved one. Trials will come from all over the place in order to test and shake your faith. But Jesus Christ said, if you build upon the word, those storms and trials will come, but they will go. And you will be standing. Can I tell you that the devil is not interested in your position? The devil is not interested in your car? The devil is not interested in your house? The reason why the devil is touching your house and touching your family and touching all of those things is to penetrate your heart. The moment you guard your heart with the word of God and you don't allow the enemy with all that he's doing, you can say like Job, one thing I know, my Redeemer liveth. All your losses, all that people thought that you have lost in your life, when the test is over, and God comes to reward you because you stood firm according to the word of God, you're going to have a double return of God's blessings. Your later end will be greater than your former. Don't allow the present test, the present trial, to make you lose your faith in Christ. Hold on to the living word of God. I am persuaded that neither death, nor hunger, nor tribulation shall separate us from the love of God. The greatest asset, the greatest thing that you must crave for is the living word of God. It is the only one that can give you a lifetime impact. The word of God. How do you establish this word? Let me give you five things quickly. Number one, accept the word of God as the final authority. Don't accept the voice of the devil. Don't accept the Nigerian constitution. Don't accept the system around you or the system of the world as the final authority. Accept the word of God as the final authority over your life. The word must become the authoritative standard for everything that you do. The Bible must become the compass. It must become the instrument you rely on in the journey of your life. For every decision you make, for the directions you need, for whatever discussions you're going to have, let the word of God govern what you do. Let the word of God be the final authority. If I'm going to take a decision, this decision I'm taking, is it in line with the word of God? Does the word of God subscribe to it or not? If the word of God does not, and the world subscribe to, you will reject the world and go with the word. It controls your discussion. If you're sitting down with somebody and the person is bringing godless talks, godless things that don't inspire, things that don't nourish you, you dump it. Because that doesn't build your life. That doesn't build your relationship with God. I don't care how close you are to a friend. If all that the friend will be discussing around you are trash, things that don't define things, don't define purpose, don't give you direction for life, don't build you in the path of righteousness, dump that friend. That is an enemy of destiny. The word of God should be the supreme authority. I don't care what the devil comes to tell you. The devil may come and tell you that you will never make it in life. Tell the devil, devil, that's what you said. But hear the word of the Lord over my life. I shall be the head and not the tail. The righteous may fall 7 times. He will surely rise again. There is a resurrection for me. This is not the bus stop. This is not the end of the journey. I'm getting to where God has destined me for. Remind yourself of the authority of God's word. The Bible said to me that even though right now I don't have anything, I don't even have 1,000 naira to take care of my family. All I have is so little that people call us poor. Don't worry. That's a phase in my life. That's a phase in my family. What is the word of God over my life? The word of God over my life. I wish above all things that you will prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospereth. God said to me by his word, final authority, final authority, final authority. God said to me, let the poor say, I am rich. So I'm not poor. I am rich. Today I don't have food on my table. It's just a transition. It's not permanent. I'm going to come out of it. It's a journey that God is using to package my character, to package my thoughts, to package my will. God is allowing the fire so that he can pull me to prepare me for greatness. Without the experience of poverty and lack on my table, I don't have a testimony. Without people rising up to conspire against me because of the favor of God on my head, I don't have a testimony. I need people to hate me for God to promote me. And you'll be so shocked. You'll be so shocked. The least person you expect that this person hates you will be the one that will hate you. But God is preparing the one you are eating in the same plate. You need a Judas to help you go to the cross. But that does not mean that Judas is going to succeed to stop you from finishing your course. I prophesy over your life. People will look for the Judases that hated you before, that gang up against you. They will look for them. They will never find them, but you will be in the highest position. Allowing the word of God as the final authority in your life. I declare this over your life in the name that is above every name. Jesus Christ of Nazareth said, whatever my Father has not planted, whatever the word of God does not back up, that is living inside of your life, that is living in your office, that is living in your relationship, that is living in the place where you're walking, whatever my Father has not backed up, whatever my Father has not allowed, whatever my Father has not planted, it shall all be rooted out. I declare over your life today that anything outside God's word is going to be rooted out of your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Lift up your hand and say, I receive it in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I have often shared a testimony of many, many years ago. This is over 20 years now, of a miracle that happened in the life of a woman that changed my mindset. That woman was operated on in Maiduguri. They removed the womb. She had kids, about two of kids, they remove the womb. They don't want children anymore. Something happened in their life, they lost, and they wanted children. And nothing was going to work because the womb was out. But this woman in those days kept coming to where we used to have our prayer meeting every day, staying in the word, hearing the word. We can spend 5 hours just talking the word of God. At the time she least expect in her life, one of the days the presence of God enveloped the place. And ladies and gentlemen, whatever you see on earth, there is a spare part of it in heaven. Whatever you see here, this my eye I have, there is a spare part. The lungs you have, there is a spare part. The cells in your bones. Therefore, today, anything the devil has damaged in your system, the Lord is going to restore a brand new one. The word of God cannot be broken. Hallelujah. 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 The summary of the testimony was that this woman suddenly started feeling abnormal. Abnormal things in her body. Suddenly she told the husband, something strange is going on. Let's go to the hospital and check out. The husband went with her to the doctor who removed the womb. The doctor said, you're kidding. It can't ever happen. I'm the one who removed your womb. It can never happen. Are you stupid? Something is wrong with you. Get out of my office. He walked them out of his office. They came back 2 months later. He said, I said, get out. Something is, your wife is going insane. It's not possible. The third month, when men refuse the truth, the evidence will prove it. I prophesy over your life. Your life will be a proof producer. Your life will be a proof producer. Few months later, her stomach was out. And they came to the place. And the doctor said, I think we need to carry out an examination. And when they examined it under the scanner, behold, a brand new womb. Carrying a 3-month-old baby. What is it God cannot do? I have seen in my life people with twisted legs, twisted bodies. And the power of God comes to walk into their body and the bones start stretching out. What is it God cannot do? This is my 30-something years now. I was healed of tuberculosis. I was written up by the doctors. My Islamic power couldn't help me out. But when I encountered Christ, 1983, he breathed on me after my encounter. Breath on me and smile. Breath, he disappeared. That was the last day. This is now about 30 years. I've never gone to the hospital to look for a drug for tuberculosis. I'm healed forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. Lift your hand and say, Father, I accept your word as the final authority. So even when you're dying, don't agree with the devil. Say, I shall not die, but I shall live to declare the glory of God. Hallelujah. Well, I don't have time to be telling you so many things, but you have heard. Some of you probably were there in Kafanchan when I was struck with paralysis and half of my body, my mouth twisted, my hand shrink up. I fell down after I was attacked by the arrows of the enemy. Came back from such a tremendous crusade in Cameroon. And the enemy said, what shall we do? When I was crippled down, I can't talk. But in my heart, I was speaking to myself. The devil started reminding me of Baba Paul Gindry. He said people will say all over the place, Evangelist Elbuba, the miracle man, was struck and he died of stroke and paralysis. And the devil reminded me of Baba Paul Gindry. And I replied the devil in my heart, even though I couldn't talk. It is not the voice you say outside, it is the heart. I prophesy when you lose a battle in your heart, you will lose it physically. But when your heart is still retaining your place of victory, you will win the battle externally. A man loses in life, not externally first, but internally. And then, of course, at the end of the day, I told the devil, you are a liar. Began to sing. I said, I shall not die a coward. Made a sign to my wife and my son, Stephen. They came around and Stephen was crying out and said, God, that's not the covenant you have with my father. You have healed him from several infirmities. My father will not die like this. Well, finally, I made a sign to them and they called my driver, a Yoruba man with my laurel, and I saw a sign to them, they should put my babariga. Radical man, stubborn for Jesus. And I did a sign. They carried me. Mommy could not say, Daddy, where are you going to go? I said, Kafanchan. Because I was supposed to be one of the ministers. How can a stroke man, instead of hospital, I'm talking of the house of God. It's the mindset. I prophesy over your life, the devil will never sit on your head anymore. The devil will never influence your emotions anymore. I release into your veins, I release into your arteries, I release into your heart, I release into your spirit a new life from the presence of the Almighty God in the mighty name of Jesus. And you know, it is that craziness of Islam, because one thing with us that used to be Muslims, when the Quran, if a verse says so, that is what we would die for. And now I'm connected to a higher life. I'm connected to the breath of life, not a dead book led by a dead prophet, a rotten prophet in the grave. I am connected to the one that is risen and is no longer in the grave. The grave could not hold him captive. The devil is a liar to hold me captive. The devil is a liar. I hang myself upon the word. Well, finally, I was taken to Kafanchan. My friends, when they got me into the camp, Kure, Uka, all of my friends came out. They were told, they rushed out and everybody was crying. You can imagine, what would you do? You may not understand what I'm talking. If you meet top ministers, there is a situation that will say, what can we do? Which prayer can you pray for such man? So they were looking, they were all crying. And I did like this to them. So they drove me to my hotel room and took me to my guest room. They carried me and put me on the floor. And while I was on the floor, stroked, I began to sing a song in my spirit. Be magnified, O Lord, you are highly exalted, and there is nothing you can do. Oh Lord, my eyes are on you. Be magnified, oh Lord, be magnified. I'm telling you, what I saw that day, I'm seeing it right now. Tears started running down my cheek. It was not the tears of pity. It was not the tears of self-pity. It is not the tears that I am now paralyzed, stroked down. I can't talk. Saliva is coming down my mouth. But it was the tears of joy. That if my spirit is alive, my body will be alive to praise them. While I was doing that, midway, over about 30 minutes later, suddenly I felt some movement. And I heard the voice of the Lord. And the Lord said to me, my son, you have conquered. You are moving to the next level of your life. I prophesy over your life today. Every trial that will come your way, you will overcome that trial. You will overcome that temptation. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, lift up your two hands to heaven and shout it loud and clear. I accept the word of God as the final authority. Say it again with all authority. I accept the word of God as the final authority in my life. Hallelujah. 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 Sit down. And suddenly, my neck turned. A little, my mouth shifted. My hand was still. And the whole of this part of the body was down. So I got the driver. They got me to the time of the meeting. So they helped me into the meeting. I sat down with all my friends. And then it was almost getting closer to my time. Of course, that time is normal for me. But I did a sign to my friend, when it is my time, call me. How will I preach? I don't talk. Saying those things that be not as though they were. Faith is standing on the side of God, disagreeing with your feeling. Disagreeing with what the circumstances you are in. Faith is seeing yourself in what God has planned for you and not the situation around you. The situation around you is only a distraction. If you look down, you will sink. Look up to the author and to the finisher of your faith. Suddenly, my friend called me. And then I stood up. When I was standing up, the body stretched up. Something is happening. So I got to the stage in Kavanchan and I held the microphone. As I held the microphone to shout, now everybody knew me. When I come up, you hear fire. And I wanted to say, shout fire. As I opened my mouth, the mouth opened wide. My hands stretched forward. My legs stretched forward. Ladies and gentlemen, forever and ever, I'm growing younger every day, getting stronger every day, advancing the kingdom of God. I prophesy over your life that the undertakers that are waiting to bury you, they will be shocked at the news that is going to come over to them. You shall not die. You will not die. You will live. You will declare the glory of God. Lift up your hands again and say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I accept your word as the final authority over my family, over my husband, over my wife, over my children, over my body. I accept your word as a final authority. I will win. I will overcome. I will triumph to the glory of your name. In the name of Jesus. 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 I believe. It is well with me.
I believe.
Yes,
yes Lord, I believe. Yes, Lord,
I believe.
It is well with me.
It is well with me. Well with me,
I believe. Yes, Lord, I believe.
Oh,
yes, Lord, I believe.
It is well with me. It is well with me. One more time.
Lord, I believe.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord, I believe.
I believe.
Yes, Lord, I believe.
It is well with me. I'm going to pray for you right away. I won't be able to show you so many things that the word of God will help you. But if you have a pain, let me just give you those three things. Go home and meditate on it. Proverbs chapter 30 and verse 9. Verse 5. Sit down and write it. Every word of God is pure. He's a shield unto them that put their trust in him. Every word of God, everything that God says is pure. 2 Timothy chapter 3 and verse 16. The word of God, the Bible testified to us, is useful for teaching. It's useful for training. It's useful for transforming. Three things it does: teaching, training, and transforming. Now, number two, stay connected by assimilating the word of God. Now, when you accept the word of God as the final authority, assimilate it. It is not just enough to believe the Bible, but you must fill your mind with the word of God. Fill your mind with the word of God, because every day you wake up, every second you're walking on the street, the devil is bombarding your mind. The devil is trying to bring so many things to crush into your mind. But when you fill your mind with the word of God will push out the suggestions of the enemy. The word of God will raise the defenses around your head. The devil will always, I'm telling you right now, even as you're sitting here, as the word of God is coming for, the devil will remind you of something. But when the word of God is the one that controls your mind, it blocks and sends out the voice of the enemy. It arrests every spirit of rebellion. Because anything that is not in accordance to God's word is a rebellious spirit. It's a spirit that wants to destroy you. Your mind is the battleground. So assimilate the word of God. Now let me show you something that is so shocking. I read it today. I read it and I said, God, you are such an awesome God. God raised a leader and God spoke to Moses and told and said, look here, if any of my child is going to be successful, whether a businessman or somebody that is a king in government or somebody that is leading or somebody that is living for himself and doing things for himself, God said to Moses, instruct him to bring in the Levitical priest, that the priest will come with a scroll of the written instruction, and the man, the king, the governor, the ruler, the businessman, would take a pen by himself and copy the instruction with his own hands. Why? Number one, that he will not forget that he was picked from the ordinary people. Number two, that his life will be safe. That every decision he wants to make, he will be governed by the word. And then number three, because his life is being controlled by the word, the scripture says, and he shall fear the Lord, and he shall hearken unto his instruction and to his decree. Then the last word there, and his generation shall never miss out of the blessings of God. Deuteronomy chapter 17 and verse 19. Verse 19 right down to verse 20. So the assimilation, the power of God's word, it will guard your heart. It will spare you from going into error. It will save you. And that means you receive the word. You read the word of God. You research the word of God if there is a need in your life and your family. As a man, you want to know what is God's plan. What's God's word for a man? There is a word for you. What is God's position as a woman? How am I to behave? There was a word for you. What's the word of God as a child? You research the word of God. Remember always the word of God. Remind yourself of God's promises. Reflect on the word of God. As you sit in your office and you're confused, reflect. I told them in Lagos, I said, Isaac Newton, historian, said, whenever he's confused on his research, whatever he's trying to do, whenever he's confused, he stops and then goes to the Bible. There is the Bible beside him all the time. And he will open the Bible, read the Bible, see the promises of God, and then his brain will open up into new research. And that was how Isaac Newton was able to bring forth several laws that today is governing virtually most of the things we do. The word of God, reflecting on the word of God, that is assimilation. And then finally, number three, to stay connected, you must apply the principles of God's word. When the word of God talks about giving, apply that principle. It is more blessed to give than to what? To receive. Love your enemies and do good to them that hate you. What's the principle? Love them. If your enemy comes and he asks for food, give him. That's the living word of God. The word of God, when you follow the principles of God's word and the patterns of God's word, you follow the scriptural instruction. Look at what the Bible says in James chapter 1 and verse 22. But be the doer of the message, not merely listeners to it. When you just listen to the word of God and you're not a doer, the applier, you don't apply the word of God. The Bible says, look at the next thing in this translation, you're betraying yourself into deception. When I hear the word of God and I don't do it, you know what I'm doing? I'm betraying myself into deception. I'm actually destroying myself. Jesus Christ said in Matthew chapter 7 and verse 24, therefore, whosoever heareth the saying of mine and doeth them, it's not just hearing now, but what? Doeth them. I will liken him unto a wise man which built his house upon a rock. The storm, the wind, the rains will come, but the house will stand. John chapter 13 and verse 17, I close with these scriptures. Every one of us, we want God's blessings. Every one of us, we want God to lift us to greater heights. That's why God has brought all of us here. That's why you crave for this opportunity, for you to be in this service today. Even though there's no space, you crave for the word of God. Because whenever God wants to change your life, he will send you a voice. God will send you an instrument that represents him. And the Bible says to us that as long as Uzziah was the king, Uzziah was the governor, Uzziah was the leader, but the Bible says as long as Uzziah hearkened to the voice and to the words of his pastor Zechariah and does according to the instruction of Zechariah, God blessed him and made him to prosper. The Bible says that believe in the Lord your God and you shall what? You shall prosper. Believe in his prophet and you shall what? Be established. That's the living word of God. By a prophet, the people are delivered from bondage. By a prophet, they are preserved. Everything that God will do, he will bring you under a leadership. A word spoken into your life, the application of that word, may it be done unto me according to your word. Whatever he seeth unto you, do it. Even though it's illogical, it's politically incorrect, it is not right in the normal human sense. How can you use the dirty water? If it was in the days of Jesus, all of you here, before you got into this hall, your feet would have been washed because of the dust. Now, it was that dirty water that Jesus was going to tell people, go and fetch and bring to the table. That's stupidity. But whenever God wants to speak, whenever God wants to change your life, he will give you a very tough instruction. Here is a rich man who came to the man of God. He's used to those his local priests that used to worship. Now he came and met a principal man of God. He came and met a man that is disciplined and raised by God's own divine process. And when he came around, he thought that he's going to see the man of God rush out and say, the big general has come. We're going to have some offerings today. Now, when he was told the report of Naaman, he said, go and tell him. He should go and wash. I don't know which river is in Abuja here that is so dirty. But go and wash in the most dirty river. And the man said, what? This man heard that I'm here. He didn't even come out to say hi. That's number one. Number two, does it mean there are no rivers that he would tell me to go and wash there? Thank God for a little maid. She said to him, sir, in this place is a different thing from that place. Whatever he say, even if he say, go and bury yourself 1 million times, go. I say, is that so? Yes. And then he went. Chokwai, one. I wish it is only once. Chokwai, two. I wish it's only two. Chokwai, three. 7 times in the dirty water. But when the obedience was complete, he walked out healed from leprosy. Today, I'm going to give you the blessing. Bow down on your knees wherever you are now. Jesus Christ said in the scriptures, he said, if you hear my word and you do it, the Lord God will bless you. Lift your hands to heaven on your knees now. That's all I have come for. Come to remind you on how to stay connected. This is the tool you need for the remaining days of your life to move over into the next year victoriously. Raise those hands to God. Every eye is closed. Father, I thank you. Daddy, I give you the glory. Father, I have come to declare your counsel. And out of this holy mouth, whatever I curse is curse. Whatever I bless is blessed. Father, I release this blessing on your children. Holy Spirit, I honor you. I thank you for your presence. Thank you, Jesus. Father, anyone that is contending with your children, whether principality or personality, whether human or spirit, today I sentence them to eternal judgment. Almighty Father, this is my desire. Every ancestral problem, whenever they are closer to their breakthrough, it would manifest and it would take away their glory. Today, I destroy that ancestral pollution in the mighty name of Jesus. My Father, I pray. I came on an apostolic prophetic visit. This visit of few hours is worth a lifetime of labor. I declare over your life in the name that is above all names that your ears will not hear a bad news for your destruction. Your eyes will not shed the tears of sorrow. I declare over you, wherever your soul has been taken, wherever the enemy has stolen your soul, you're not enjoying yourself. Today, I reclaim your soul and restore it back to you in the name of Jesus. I restore your soul in the mighty name of Jesus. I restore your soul in the mighty name of Jesus. I restore your soul in the mighty name of Jesus. I restore your joy. I restore your confidence. I restore your joy. I restore your confidence. Everything you have done before that has even offended heaven, I stand as your mediator by the blood of Jesus. And I declare that because you have owned up, because you have cried, because you said you're sorry, your sins are forgiven you in the mighty name of Jesus. Your errors are forgiven you in the mighty name of Jesus. Because the Lord has given me the power to retain and the power to forgive and to release. Today, by the blood of Jesus Christ, I stand as God's representative on earth. And I declare that whatever has been written over and against you, whatever has been written for your destruction, today I wipe them out by the blood of Jesus Christ. I release peace. Peace into your heart. Peace into your spirit. I restore your joy. I restore your spirit. I restore your joy in the Lord. I restore your sanity. I pray today, whatever burden the enemy has placed on your shoulder, I command that burden to be lifted up your shoulder. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray over you that whatever disease or infirmity, whatever disease, that same Jesus who is the same yesterday, today, and forever, I command that sickness, I command that disease, I flush them out of your body system in the mighty name of Jesus. Be healed from your head to your toe. You will not die. You will not die. Any one of you that your name has been written for death, you've been sentenced to death already, I command that sentence cancel and nullify in the mighty name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, I pray these blessings All these hands that are raised. In the realm of the spirit, I anoint your forehead. I anoint your forehead. Where others are rejected, you're going to be celebrated. You will enjoy uncommon favor. Even though people are plotting against you like they plotted against Daniel, you are going to come out of that lion's den. Your promotion is coming. Your promotion is going to be greater. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Anyone the devil has steered out to frustrate you, they will be frustrated by the power of God. I stretch my holy hands over all of you. Oh God, as I leave you with the grace that every garment of shame, I strip them off your life in your present and in your future. My God, the God of Ebomi, he will fight those who fight you. He will contend with those who contend with you. I bless you as a father. I bless you with the blessing of Abraham. I bless you with the blessing of Isaac. I bless you with the blessing of Israel. I declare over your life, where there is confusion, go. Peace have returned. I speak restoration into your life. I declare that from now, that dream you have, as you roll them out, the Lord will make them fruitful in the mighty name of Jesus. I destroy every covenant of barrenness over your life and your family. I declare that before December closes, that job you're looking for, you're going to have it. I declare that that loan, you're going to settle it. I declare over your life, and I speak life into your life. I declare that while others are dying around you, you're going to live to declare the glory of God. Now I release the angels of the Lord. I feel the hand of God all over this place. I command in the name of Jesus. I command your lifting now. I command your lifting every hour. I command your lifting every second. I command your lifting every moment. I command your lifting every month. Between now and the month of March, your life is going to go higher. Your life is going to go higher. Your life is going to go higher. You will enjoy the favor of God. Today, I separate your life from anything that makes you to disobey God. Anything that makes you to always go to the will of the flesh. Today, I take your flesh and nail them to the cross. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. As I leave you with a grace. That from now, all the days of your life, you'll be number one in the house of God. You'll be number one in the house of God. If God is going to see anybody, he's going to celebrate. God is going to celebrate you. You're going to be a faithful instrument in the hand of God. I sanctify your life. I sanctify your family. I sanctify your husband. I sanctify your wife. I sanctify your children. I bring forth your life partner. And I declare over your life that from now, everything about your life is going to be functional. It's going to be functional. I solve that financial problem. I bring into your life what you need. Whatever it is, the desire of your heart, receive the desire of your heart. 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 In the name of Jesus. 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 Anyone that is attempting to steal your birthright, I cut them off in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever they are planning against you, I command that plan to come on their head 10 times. Every evil thought they are planning in their heart in order to see your downfall, I command them to receive 7 portions. You will enjoy the opposite. You will enjoy the glory of God. You will enjoy eternal exaltation. Wherever you go, your life will be an expression of the glory of God. Today, I inscribe and write this word on your heart. I write this word in your spirit. I leave you with this grace. May the Lord bless you. May he cause his face to shine upon you. May the Lord be gracious to you. May the Lord defend his name in your life. May the Lord always make you a living testimony, even now and forevermore.